Okay, so another International Reggae Day. Sadly, some people have passed. I know you've got a number you want to remember. Can you tell us who's the first?
Indeed, yeah, good afternoon. Once again, we know it's our annual presentation, annual event. Now, you did mention people who have passed, icons who have passed in the music fraternity over the years. Over the years, should I say. I mentioned June English. I mentioned Ray Carless. I mentioned Jah Shaka. I will mention Gerry Anderson. And I'll mention Mr. McLean, our very own. It's touching, he just passed last week. Yeah. Huh? Leslie McNeil. I call him Mr. McLean because he resembles somebody else. Leslie McNeil was his name. So I suppose we could make brief mention of Linda Johnson Isaacs and also Carlton Coffey. Carlton Coffey, brief mention. He was the first lead singer for Inner Circles before Jacob May.
Okay, so you gotta mention the first artist and what
right.
song.
Okay, first artist. Touching. June English. June English passed away in April of this year. He was a child star from Jamaica. Migrated to the United Kingdom. He arrived here in the United Kingdom in 1962 as a child. He was a child star from Jamaica with Prince Buster. He arrived here in 1962. Attended school and on leaving school embarked on a career in singing and music. Became a household name here in England, making hits after hits after hits. June English was synonymous with Jamaican reggae hits here in the United Kingdom because he transformed, he transcended with the Jamaican movements over here, even though he started as a child. He was absolutely magnificent, a magnificent fellow. Made so much contribution to this community because he.
You haven't mentioned this song.
Yeah, the song that I want to dedicate is a song he sung, one of his big sellers, entitled Never Win, Never Lose, by himself, June English. Magnificent song. Artist number two that I wish to mention is Leslie McNeil. I call him McLean, Mr. McLean, as a nickname. Leslie McLean was an amazing fella. He was a founder member of the group and band called Tradition. And he was also a member who pioneered record business, record shops from the very early 70s. Venture Records,
He was the one who initiated Venture Records way back in the early 1970s.
I thought it was Tyrone.
Sorry?
I thought it was Tyrone.
No, he was the one. Leslie was the man behind it all. Tradition was there. Tyrone was a part of it. He was one of them, one of the members. It was a group of them, three or four of them together. He was the main man. It was Leslie that I knew. It was Leslie that I gave a song. I gave him their first hit song, and by, a tune called Forget Me Now by Ronnie Davis. It was given to me, and I gave it to them because I never had a record shop at the time, and they had one. That was way back in 1974.
Do you say you gave him records to sell or records
to promote
yeah.
and release on Venture Label? It is actually my stuff, but I gave it to him. Not my stuff, it was given to me, and I handed it on to them because I didn't have the resources at the time. Hawkeye Records were not open until 1977, and they were actually open from about 74. Magnificent fella. He lived for the music. He lived for the business. And sadly, he passed away in June. A remarkable fella, Leslie McLean. Sorry, McNeil. Mr. McLean.
So what song are you going to choose?
I'm dedicating the song by the tradition. In fact, I wanted to do two, but I
go for two. Go for two. Go for two.
Go for two.
I promise to give you. I promise to say I do. When we walk down the aisle, you promise to love me too. So I'll give you, I'll give you, I'll promise you, I'll promise you. Remember I
Next up, this is a shaka. This is a shaka. His name is Jah Shaka, aka Neville Powell. Hardly anybody knows his real name. His real name is Neville Powell. He died, surprisingly, to a heart attack in April of 2023. Shaka was something special in this business, trust me. Shaka was the one, Shaka, known as Shaka Zulu, his nickname was Shaka Zulu, was a man who pioneered dub music here in England. No one could match him. He played dub through and through, really played a 45 record. Dub, he attracted audience from all over the world, cosmopolitan audiences, as I'm talking about. Whether it be Chinese, Indian, white, black, pink, or blue, no matter what religion or creed or color, he attracted them. And he had the movement, he had the style, generated that ambiance, you know, and that intrigue. He was a very, 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 very talented man in his own way. He had his own thing, very authentic. Everything he did was authentic. He played on an authentic old turntable from way back when. Old fashioned amplifier with a valve. He kept it. He was an authentic fella. Like I said, Shaka was a pioneer in that field and that genre of dub music. There's no one, no one could match him. And now that dub music has withered away, so to speak, I don't think that anyone would ever, ever walk in the shoes of Jah Shaka. He was a master of the arts. Dub through and through. A great loss to the business because he was a character. Wherever he went, home and abroad, he drew crowd. He drew massive crowds all over the continent, anywhere in England. Shaka is a special man. Funny enough, he is a Jamaican born. But he was, I would call him a Windrush child because he came here in England in the late 50s. So he's part of that generation, the Windrush generation, as a youngster, as a child. He actually died, he was age 75 when he died, so he's not exactly a spring chicken, but at least he was a youngish man. A remarkable player, Jah Shaka.
Yeah.
He passed, sadly.
Yeah. So what track of his would you like to remember?
Well, it's not his track, it's a track that I would dedicate to him. Warrior Charge by Aswad.
Absolutely, 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 yes. I'm sure he must have played it many a time because it's just his type of music,
yeah,
for sure.
Kind of, he's a chanting and he's a Rasta man as well, for sure.
Yeah. And he's an IRD award winner, just
yes,
like
indeed.
You.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, thanks very much.
Yes.
And I tell you what, he was such a character. The man, I sold him, he used to call me Dub Roy. And I remember I sold Shaka more than 100 dubs. I used to sell dubs back in the day. Shaka was my customer. He used to say, Dub Roy, put them under the bed, I'll come back for them. And he turned up with his money. Oh, he was a hell of a fella back in the day. You know, I used to say to myself, oh, wait, why is he doing with so many dubs? But he knew what he was doing. Yeah, and he knew, you know, it transcended that he became the master. The icon.
Next?
All next right. Up, it's touching, but I have to mention Gerald Hawkeye Anderson, stalwart of Hawkeye Records, a company that I created in 1974. Gerry joined me in 1977 when this record shop was open. He was with me on up to the time of his death in November 22. Gerry was synonymous with Hawkeye Records. He has been here from foundation, even when I wasn't here. I was away studying and visiting, going abroad during the studio. Gerry was always here. He opened the door and he closed it. He was the man who was here. People would come in, they'd ask for Gerry. He was the encyclopedia of reggae music. Gerry knew everything about reggae music. Anything you want to know about music, you talk to Gerry and you give it an answer. Any record you want, you tell him what you want and Gerry won't get it for you. It was that kind of character. He dedicated his life to the business, to the company, to the community. He was a community servant, I would say. My brother from another mother. I won't dwell too much because then you might say I'm biased. But Gerry was very, very, very special to me. Without Gerry, I don't think Hawkeye would have been Hawkeye as it is today. Hawkeye sound system. Yeah.
So you know, what song? I think I know what song, but what song are you going to use to dedicate to his memory?
There's so many of our production, Hawkeye production, that could be dedicated, but I know the one that touches Jerry's heart. I dedicate the song, Key to the World, to Jerry, because Jerry was the man who had the key to Hawkeye Records, and that was his world. A song by Rudy Thomas, the late Rudy Thomas, it was produced by me. And should I say Hawkeye Records, because not only me, it's a company, we produced it. And it was a massive hit. And Jerry deserved to be remembered by that song.
I have the key to the world.
To mention Mr. Ray Carless, saxophonist extraordinaire, humble, humane man, a man who homegrown with the British product, really believe. And he operated here in England. Relatively, I would say he was an unsung hero, because he played on so many songs that you wouldn't even know that Ray was on it. He was magnificent, he made his contribution, and we honor him. Also, I'd like to mention Mr. Joe White, a Jamaican, from way back when. He started from the very old days of Coxon, Pottinger, Joe Creed, etc. He was a magnificent contributor, singing songs like Pretty Little Black Girl, Are You Marianne? Remember that one? Every Night, My Guiding Star. You know, he was magnificent. He also passed away in 2022. There are many more, but you know, time does not permit the mentioning of all. You know, I think I put a full stop there. And thank you very much.
No, thank you, Mr. Roy Hawkeye Forbes-Allen. Thank you for, you know, remembering those that are past. We appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
Pass the dutchie on the left hand side. Pass the dutchie on the left hand side. It have a ball.
Give me the music, make me jump and prom.
It have a ball.
Give me the music, make me jump in a ding dong. Come and say listen to the drum, and me say listen to the bass. Give me little music, make me wind up me waist. Me say listen to the drum, and me say listen to the bass. Give me little music, make me wind up me waist. I say,
pass the dutchie on the left hand side.
I say,
chip on the left hand side, it a go bun.
Give me the music, make me jump and prom.
It a go done.
Give me the music, make me look in at the dance. You play it on the radio, and so me say we a go hear it on the stereo. And so me know we a go play it on the disco. And so me say we a go hear it on the stereo. Stereo.
Pass the dutch chip on the left hand side.
Come on me. Mankind is full of war and hatred. Oh yes, yes. Can't you see what is happening in the world today? It's too much war. of war, yes. Nation is rising up against nation, oh yes, yes. On their way to total destruction, with fighting over here, fighting over there.